गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 5 ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री 2. दैट इज द एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज दैट टू आइडेंटिफाई द गिवन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड बाय सिस्टमैटिक क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस. इन एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 3 यू ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई द कंपाउंड by this way, that is systematic qualitative analysis. It is second compound that you have to identify. You know the steps involved in qualitative analysis. Preliminary test, you have to perform physical constant, elemental analysis, group analysis, and lastly you have to go for confirmatory test. See, our today's compound, which is liquid in nature and it is insoluble in water. First you have to go for their solubility. It is liquid in, first their state is liquid and their color, it is colorless compound and it is insoluble in water. We take our compound in dropper. See, blue litmus doesn't turns red and red litmus doesn't turn blue. So this compound is neutral in nature. See, with sodium bicarbonate solution, it shows no effervescence, so it is not acidic in nature, so it is neutral in nature. Our unknown compound also have an deep sweet smell. See, the next test, that is action of reagent, you have to take the action of cold NaOH solution. So we take 3 drop of our unknown compound, 2 ml water and 10% NaOH solution. It gives an sweet smell. So the compound may be chloroform. See, the next test is the action of potassium permanganate solution. So we take our liquid solution, unknown liquid, and the potassium permanganate solution. So no decolorization it shows. That is the compound is saturated. The next test is bromine water take. We take our compound 3 ml, our solution, unknown solution, 3 ml plus bromine water. It shows no coloration, that is no decolorization or precipitate get form. That is the compound is saturated. The next test is action of FeCl3 solution. So we take our compound, that is liquid solution, then you have to add water and a drop of FeCl3 solution. So no blue violet color is produced. So phenol is absent. No sooty flame get produced when we heat the compound. The next test is action with soda lime. When we heat our unknown compound with soda lime, it gives a chloroform like odor. On the basis of preliminary test, that we conclude that our unknown compound, it is aliphatic in nature, it is saturated, and it is basic in nature. The next step is that determination of physical constant. In experiment number 3, you studied that how to determine the boiling point. So the boiling point of the given unknown organic compound was found to be 61 degrees Celsius. The next step is that elemental analysis. For elemental analysis, you have to perform the Lusigen extract. You know that how to prepare Lusigen extract by sodium fusion test. For elemental analysis, we have to take this Lusigen extract. After taking Lusigen extract, we have to perform nitrogen test. After doing the procedure for test for nitrogen, there is a no blue color or green color produced, so nitrogen is absent. The next test is that test for sulfur. You know the procedure for test for sulfur that you studied in last experiment. So there is a no purple color produced, so sulfur is also absent. The next test is test for halogen. For this you have to take 5 ml filtrate. After taking filtrate, you have to boil it. Add sulfuric acid and you have to boil this solution. Add HNO3 solution and few drops of AgNO3 solution. See, it shows white curdy precipitate, that is halogens are present. On the basis of elemental analysis, the given organic compound found to be contain the carbon, hydrogen and halogens, this element. As our compound unknown sample contain carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and halogen, we have to perform next step, that is functional group detection. In functional group detection, you have to perform the first test. You have to take 1 ml of substance, and in that we have to add 2 to 4 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid. So observe that it is insoluble in sulfuric acid. See, two separate layers are observed. So the inference is that aliphatic hydrocarbons may be present because it is insoluble in sulfuric acid. The next test, that is the test sample, means unknown liquid you have to take, then add NaOH solution and boil it. After boiling, we have to acidify the solution with HNO3. And lastly, we have to add AgNO3 solution and shake it. So it shows an precipitate. So inference is that aromatic halogen substituted compound may be present, like chloroform, chlorobenzene may be present. On the basis of functional group detection, we conclude that our compound contains halogen. So no functional group is detected. It is saturated compound containing halogen. So the given organic compound was found to be having 61 boiling point, and it consists of carbon, hydrogen and chlorine element, and also, and on the basis of literature, reference to literature, the compound may be chloroform. So we have to go for the confirmatory test for chloroform. See the confirmatory test. In that we have to boil small amount of test sample. So we already boiled the test sample, and with you have to then with the solution of few crystal of resorcinol in 2 to 3 ml of dilute NaOH solution. We have to take resorcinol crystal in that and add 2 to 3 ml of dilute NaOH solution. See, we observed red color, that is chloroform is confirmed. See, it is the structure of chloroform, which is a colorless liquid and having sweet odor, that is cucumber like odor. See the structure of chloroform, it is an organic solvent.